Welcome, fans of Flip Clocks. Today we're talking about the Hail Caesar Flip Clock that was first seen in the trailers for the movie Hail Caesar, which we're going to look at one of these trailers right now in its entirety.
Here at Capitol Pictures, we have the biggest movie stars in the world. But seriously, we have your movie star.
What?
Ed Whitlock has been kidnapped.
This is bad.
The studio needs your help. Go out there and find him. I need $100,000.
Is it hard squeezing it like that?
We don't want it in the gossip columns.
This is a real drama.
Hail Caesar. Rated PG-13.
And there you have it. Hail Caesar, featuring the now known as the Hail Caesar Flip Clock, the General Electric Model 8113. And we just so happen to have one of these clocks right here in the Flip Clock Fan Studio. It happens to be a very nice-looking clock. It's Art Deco. It's got a 50s look, and it's probably why they chose the clock. But as many of you know, flip clocks weren't actually made until the late 1960s, and this clock itself was produced in the early 1970s. Still, it's a very nice-looking wooden clock, and we're going to take a closer look at it. As you can see, it's the General Electric Model 8113, 120 volts, 60 hertz. There's the wheel to adjust the clock setting. What we're going to look at particularly is the type of motor used in this clock. Some of the older Panasonics had a motor like this where there's an electronic field there created, and the motor part itself is actually encapsulated, and there's a wheel in there that spins because of the magnetic field. And in the Panasonics, they didn't hold up very well, but in these clocks, I've not seen one that did not work. So here we're looking at the mechanics, and as you might notice, if you're familiar with the other flip clocks, and there's a lot more metal here than you'd normally see. Now, I've actually seen it erroneously stated that these pages are made out of metal. They're not. They're definitely plastic. Now, I want you to count the number of sevens. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, that's unusual. In the later flip clocks, there's only 2 of each hour depicted, but this clock's kind of unusual that way. It may seem kind of strange to have more than one hour number anyway, but that's just the way the engineers came up with keeping the minute and the hour wheel synchronized in these clocks. A very nice looking clock, very solid. I'm rolling the wheel on the bottom there to flip that around. You're looking at these brass legs. Now the back has an interesting different colored wood, which I think actually looks kind of snazzy, but we're going to look at that a little more here. Now you'll see that this case on the left here, it has Japan stamped, and most of them do, and in this case here on the right does not. And it's hand-stamped because they're different qualities, these stamps, you'll see. So if we look at the case, we'll see that the back is actually made out of plywood. You can see the layers right there.
This is bad.
It's not necessarily bad. It's just interesting because the rest of the clock is made out of solid wood. And we'll take this down here. We'll see that the front of the clock is actually made from plexiglass.
This is bad.
And again, I don't think that's a bad thing. This doesn't seem to scratch too bad. You could replace it with glass, I suppose. Now, the bezel, I guess you'd call it here, is made from plastic. You can see the marks here from when it was in the mold. It's been painted. There's a little overspray on the backside, but it's been painted kind of a matte finish, gold, in the lettering for General Electric. We'll go back into the internals of the clock just to get kind of a 360 look here at the clock. And as you can see, all that metal construction in the gears. This clock is definitely made to last, and they function quite well to this day. And there you have it, the General Electric Model 8113, now known as the Hail Caesar Flip Clock. Highly recommended clock, and highly recommended movie. If you get the chance, come visit us at flipclockfans.com.